This is Apple's latest launch and it's so value for money, it's already started ranking on Amazon's bestseller page. Yes, it's the Mac Mini with M4 chipset, 16GB RAM in the base variant, and it costs only 60,000 rupees, which is just insane for the kind of performance it brings. I'll tell you all about it, so hit the like button because it's going to be very interesting. And now, let's get started. First of all, the new Mac Mini is tiny as duck. Just look how small this is compared to an older Mac Mini. It's just 5 by 5 inches in size, weighs a little over 1/2 kilogram, and fits easily within your palm. It's slightly thicker than last year's Mini, but it's almost the same size as Apple TV box. Although it shed a lot, there's not a lot of compromise in terms of ports, and that's just not Apple. You get 2 fast Type-C ports and a headphone jack on the front, and 3 Type-C Thunderbolt 4 ports, an HDMI port and Ethernet port on the back. I just wish Apple also kept the USB-A ports, just like previous Mac Minis. And if you're wondering where's the power button, well, it's treated as a hidden feature because it sits right at the bottom. Not sure why, because they could have put it anywhere on the sides, but Apple being Apple. I think putting essential things at the bottom is a design language that Apple dearly loves. Other than that, it's the same aluminium build with a plastic bottom, but due to its size reduction, air circulation has changed. There's a circular vent at the bottom that pulls in air from the front and throws out from the back. See, as much as I love this tiny form factor, I just want to point out one thing that if Apple wanted, they could have reduced the size of Mini when they first launched the M series chipsets, but it's okay because they have finally done it. Now that we're done talking about the size, let's understand why they say that size doesn't matter, because this thing proves exactly that. This Mac Mini is powered by the latest 3nm M4 chipset with 10-core CPU, 10-core GPU and 16-core neural engine with 38 TOPS. Plus you get 256GB SSD, and for the first time ever, Apple is giving 16GB RAM in the base variant, which is awesome. But what's not awesome is that 256GB is far from enough, because when I was setting up the Mac, I started installing benchmarks and games, and within 20 minutes, I ran out of storage. So yeah, just like RAM, Apple should also upgrade the base storage to 512GB, because that's just basic necessity. Maybe next year. Right, Apple? While working for this video, I also saw some teardown videos. Looks like Mac Mini does have a removable SSD that is not soldered. So if you're into DIYs, you can try that, but do note that this will void the warranty. Okay, it's time to check out the benchmark results. In CPU benchmarks, I was just surprised to see that M4 scores are the best. And even in multi-core, it comes very close to M2 Max with 32GB RAM. In fact, M4 numbers are better than Intel and AMD laptop CPUs that we have tested recently. Even in Cinebench R24, it's the same story. M4 takes the lead in single core and comes very close in multi-core. In GPU scores, the improvement from M1 to M4 is almost the double in Metal scores, but it can't compete with Pro or Max series as of yet because of the lack of GPU cores. But it's still a huge improvement, and it shows in video editing and gaming, which I'll come to in a bit. I also ran Geekbench AI, and the scores are impressive. Plus, it was quite snappy to respond to local LLM queries, which I was running through LLM Studio. Lastly, storage speeds are also quite impressive, as Apple is using 2 NAND chips this time. Now, I know that a lot of you might be using this machine for photo editing, so I also ran Puget Bench, and the results are very impressive. And even when I was making some changes in various layers of the thumbnail, it was just breezing through the task quite easily, and there was no issues whatsoever. So yeah, it's quite capable of handling Photoshop. And if you're into video editing, we ran an FTP project of one of our long-form 4K videos. The timeline was smooth, adding effects was fine, and the render was also very quick. In After Effects, the render was pretty fast, but there was some delay in the timeline, so we had to use it in quarter or half quality for a better playback. Overall, this is a very good entry-level photo and video editing machine if you're entering into this field for the first time, or handling smaller projects, or maybe editing short-form videos. But if your work involves a lot of After Effects, then you need a better machine. See, this is not an ideal machine for gaming, but some of you still want to know if you can game on it, so let's play. First, I played Death Stranding. It was running at 60 to 70 FPS with awesome graphics, which I honestly didn't expect from a Mac. I also played Stray, and it was also running very smoothly with consistent 60 to 70 FPS. By the way, I also tried running Death Stranding in 4K, and it ran around 30 FPS, and the gameplay was decent enough. One interesting thing that I noticed, while gaming, the power draw was just 50 watts, even with an external monitor connected, which is very good for a tiny machine like this. Now, you must be wondering if the machine gets hot because it's tiny and powerful. Well, I tested with 30 minutes of continuous gameplay on a controller, and the maximum temperature in the hottest area was around 43 degrees, which is pretty okay. I also didn't hear the fan crank up like crazy. So yeah, it's tiny, powerful, and still stays cool. Apart from demanding tasks, Mac Mini runs very smoothly in day-to-day usage too. It's running on macOS Sequoia 15.1, and the main highlight is the Apple Intelligence, but it's not available in India as of yet. But you can get it by changing your region to US, and once you do that, that, you get all the Apple Intelligence features. There are new writing tools and Siri features, which are pretty useful and they work well too. Oh, I almost forgot. You have to tell your parents that you need it for coding, so yeah, it does that too. I also went on and opened 30 to 40 Chrome tabs to see how it reacts, but it just doesn't. Everything was smooth and the fan also didn't make any noise at all. Throughout my testing, I couldn't hear the fan at all. And lastly, Mac Mini supports up to 3 displays, which is really nice because M2 was limited to only 2 displays. And the speakers are also improved a lot this time. Plus you get Wi-Fi 6E and Bluetooth 5.3 support on this one. Finally, should you buy the Mac Mini 4? Well, the answer is yes, definitely. Why not? Go for it. Yes, because it's the most powerful chipset you can get in 60,000 rupees. It's very good for day-to-day usage, coding, video editing, and even casual gaming. But if you're a student, you can get some student discounts too, which makes it even better. But yeah, do note that 256GB is not enough, so you might need to get an external SSD. But other than that, it's definitely the best Apple product of 2024 because it's priced so well. So yeah, that's it from my side. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Other than Mac Mini, what other Apple products do you think are super well you for money? Tell us in comments. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. It was always me versus me. It was never me versus you. Misunderstood. Get up, had to beat those eyes. Gotta been a beat.